angel of the Lord brought tidings to Mary,
and she conceived by the Holy Spirit.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
Behold the handmaid of the Lord.
Be it unto me according to your word.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
And the Word was made flesh,
and dwelt among us.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
Pray for us, Holy Mother of God,
that we may be made worthy of the promises of Christ.
We beseech you, O Lord, to pour your grace into our hearts, that as we have known the incarnation of your Son, Jesus Christ, by the message of an angel, so by his cross and passion we may be brought to the glory of his resurrection. Through the same Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Lord, open our lips,
and our mouth shall proclaim your praise.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. The Lord is full of compassion and mercy. Come, let us adore him. Come, let us sing to the Lord. Let us shout for joy to the rock of our salvation. Let us come before his presence with thanksgiving, and raise a loud shout to him with psalms. For the Lord is a great God, and a great King above all gods. In his hand are the caverns of the earth, and the heights of the hills are his also. The sea is his, for he made it, and his hands have molded the dry land. Come, let us bow down and bend the knee, and kneel before the Lord our Maker. For he is our God, and we are the people of his pasture, and the sheep of his hand. Oh, that today you would hearken to his voice. The Lord is full of compassion and mercy. Come, let us adore him. Psalms 70 and 71. Be pleased, O God, to deliver me. O Lord, make haste to help me.
Let those who seek my life be ashamed and altogether dismayed. Let those who take pleasure in my misfortune draw back and be disgraced.
Let those who say to me, aha, and gloat over me, turn back. Because they are ashamed.
Let all who seek you rejoice and be glad in you. Let those who love your salvation say forever, great is the Lord.
But as for me, I am poor and needy. Come to me speedily, O God.
You are my helper and my deliverer. O Lord, do not tarry.
In you, O Lord, have I taken refuge. Let me never be ashamed.
In your righteousness, deliver me and set me free. Incline your ear to me and save me.
Be my strong rock, a castle to keep me safe. You are my crag and my stronghold.
Deliver me, my God, from the hand of the wicked, from the clutches of the evildoer and the oppressor.
For you are my hope, O Lord God. My confidence since I was young.
I have been sustained by you ever since I was born. In my mother's womb you have been my strength. My praise shall be always of you.
I have become a portent to many. You are my refuge and my strength.
Let my mouth be full of your praise. And your glory all the day.
Do not cast me off in my old age. Forsake me not when my strength fails.
those who lie in wait for my life take counsel together.
They say, God has forsaken him. Go after him and seize him, because there is none who will save.
O God, be not far from me. Come quickly to help me, O my God.
Let those who set themselves against me be put to shame and be disgraced. Those who seek to do me evil be covered with scorn and reproach.
But I shall always wait in patience, and shall praise you more and more.
My mouth shall recount your mighty acts and saving deeds all day long. Though I cannot know the number of them,
I will begin the mighty works of the Lord God. I will recall your righteousness, yours alone.
O God, you have taught me since I was young. And to this day I tell of your wonderful works.
And now that I am old and gray-headed, O God, do not forsake me. Till I make known your strength to this generation and your power to all who are to come.
Your righteousness, O God, reaches to the heavens. Done great things. Who is like you, O God?
You have showed me great troubles and adversities. But you will restore my life and bring me up again from the deep places of the earth.
You strengthen me more and more. You enfold and comfort me.
Therefore I will praise you upon the lyre for your faithfulness, O my God. I will sing to you with the harp, O Holy One of Israel.
My lips will sing with joy when I play to you. And so will my soul, which you have redeemed.
My tongue will proclaim your righteousness all day long. For they are ashamed and disgraced who sought to do me harm. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit,
as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
The book of the prophet Jeremiah, the fourth chapter, beginning at the ninth verse. On that day, says the Lord, courage shall fail the king and the officials. Priests shall be appalled, and the prophets astounded. Then I said, Ah, Lord God, how utterly you have deceived this people in Jerusalem, saying, It shall be well with you, even while the sword is at the throat. My anguish, I writhe in pain. Oh, the walls of my heart is beating wildly, I cannot keep silent, for I hear the sound of the trumpet, the alarm of war. Disaster overtakes disaster, and the whole land is laid waste. Suddenly my tents are destroyed, my curtains in a moment. How long must I see the standard and hear the sound of the trumpet? For my people are foolish, they do not know me. They are stupid children and have no understanding. They are skilled in doing evil, but do not know how to do good. I looked upon the earth and below, it was waste and void, and to the heavens, and they had no light. I looked in the mountains, and lo, they were quaking, and all the hills moved to and fro. I looked, and lo, there was no one at all, and all the birds of the air had fled. I looked, and lo, the fruitful land was a desert, and all its cities were laid in ruins before the Lord, before his fierce anger. For thus says the Lord, the whole land shall be a desolation, yet I will not make a full end. Because of this the earth shall mourn, and the heavens above grow black. For I have spoken, I have proposed, I have not relented, nor will I turn back. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
O
the song of Moses. I will sing to the Lord, for he is lofty and uplifted.
The horse
and its rider has he hurled into the sea.
The Lord
is my strength and my refuge.
The Lord
has become my Savior. This is my God, and I will praise him.
The God
of my people, and I will exalt him.
The Lord
is a mighty warrior. Yahweh is his name. The chariots of Pharaoh and his army has he hurled into the sea. The finest of those who bear armor have been drowned in the Red Sea. The fathomless deep was overwhelmed them. They sank into the depths like a stone.
Your
right hand, O Lord, is glorious in might.
Your
right hand, O Lord, has overthrown the enemy. Who can be compared to you, O
Lord,
among the gods?
Who
is like you, glorious in holiness, awesome in renown,
and
worker of wonders? You stretch forth your right hand, the earth swallowed him up.
With
your constant love, you led the people you redeemed.
With
your
might,
you brought them in safety to your holy dwelling.
You
will
bring
them in and plant them
on the mount
of your possession.
The
resting place you have made for yourself, O Lord,
the sanctuary,
O Lord,
that
your
hands
have established.
The Lord
shall reign forever and ever.
Glory
to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit,
as
it was in the beginning,
is
now, and will be forever.
Amen.
The letter of Paul to the Romans, the second chapter, beginning at the 12th verse. All who have sinned apart from the law will all perish apart from the law. And all who have sinned under the law will be judged by the law. For it is not the hearers of the law who are righteous in God's sight, but the doers of the law who will be justified. When Gentiles, who do not possess the law, do instinctively what the law requires, these, though not having the law, are a law to themselves. They show that what the law requires is written in their hearts, to which their own conscience also bears witness. And their conflicting thoughts will accuse, or perhaps excuse them, on the day when, according to my gospel, God, through Jesus Christ, will judge the secret thoughts of all. But if you call yourself a Jew, and rely on the law, and boast of your relation to God, and know his will, and determine what is best because you are instructed in the law, and if you are sure that you are a guide to the blind, a light to those who are in darkness, a corrector of the foolish, teacher of children, having in the law the embodiment of knowledge and truth, you then that teach others, will you not teach yourself? While you preach against stealing, do you steal? You that forbid adultery, do you commit adultery? You that abhor idols, do you rob temples? You that boast in the law, do you dishonor God by breaking the law? For, as it is written, the name of God is blasphemed among the Gentiles. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. The Song of the Redeemed. O ruler of the universe, Lord God,
great
deeds are they that you have done, surpassing human understanding. Your ways are ways of righteousness and truth, O King of all the ages.
Who
can fail to do you homage, Lord,
and
sing the praises of your name? For you only are the Holy One. All nations will draw near and fall down before you, because your just and holy works have been revealed.
Glory
to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. I believe in God,
the Father
Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord.
He
was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit
and
born of the Virgin Mary.
He
suffered under Pontius Pilate,
was
crucified, died, and was buried.
He descended
to the dead. is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Our Father in heaven,
hallowed
be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Save your people, Lord, and bless your inheritance.
Govern and uphold them now and always.
Day by day we bless you.
We praise your name forever.
Lord, keep us from all sin today.
Have mercy on us, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, show us your love and mercy.
For we put our trust in you.
In you, Lord, is our hope.
And we shall never hope in vain.
O God, whose glory it is always to have mercy, be gracious to all who have gone astray from your ways, and bring them again with penitent hearts and steadfast faith to embrace and hold fast the unchangeable truth of your word, Jesus Christ, your Son, who with you and the Holy Spirit lives and reigns one God forever and ever. Amen. Almighty and everlasting God, you hate nothing you have made, and forgive the sins of all who are penitent. Create and make in us new and contrite hearts, that we, worthily lamenting our sins and acknowledging our wretchedness, may obtain of you, the God of all mercy, perfect remission and forgiveness, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. O God, the author of peace and lover of concord, to know you as eternal life and to serve you as perfect freedom, defend us, your humble servants, in all assaults of our enemies, that we, surely trusting in your defense, may not fear the power of any adversaries, through the might of Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty and everlasting God, by whose Spirit the whole body of your faithful people is governed and sanctified, receive our supplications and prayers which we offer before you for all members of your holy church, that in their vocation and ministry they may truly and devoutly serve you, through our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. Let us bless the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God, the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all evermore.